It is my pleasure to come before you as we prepare for the seven last words of Christ. This service, I thank each of you who have come to experience it in each your own way. Let's go before God's throne of grace and prayer. We thank you, Lord, for this day and for this opportunity. Prepare us as we will be hearing the seven last words of Christ, our Lord, through readings and through music, through the wonderful gifts of both. We ask, Lord, that we be reminded of how integral this piece is for our souls, for our faith journey, and for the life that we lead. Let it flow into us, transform us, and lead us from this place into the world, made better and strengthened. We put this time into your hands. Let it go according to your holy will. In the name of Christ our Lord, we pray. Amen.
Thank you. Luke chapter 23, verses 32 through 34. Two men, both criminals, were also led out with him to be executed. When they came to the place called the Skull, they crucified him, along with the criminals, one on the right, the other on his left. Jesus said, "Father, forgive them, for they do not know what they do." And they divided up his clothes by casting lots.
Thank you. 43. One of the criminals who hung there hurled insults at him. "Aren't you the Christ? Save yourself and us." But the other criminal rebuked him. "Don't you fear God?" he said. "Since you are under the same sentence, we are punished justly, for we are getting what our deeds deserve. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." Jesus answered him, "I tell you the truth, today you will be with me in paradise."
Thank you. John 19, verses 25 through 27. Near the cross of Jesus stood his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Clopas, and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother there, and the disciple whom he loved standing nearby, he said to his mother, "Dear woman, here is your son." And to the disciple, "Here is your mother." From that time on, the disciple took her into his home.
Thank you. hour until the ninth hour, darkness came over all the land. About the ninth hour, Jesus cried out in a loud voice, my God, why have you forsaken me?
Thank you.
fifth word. Later, knowing that all was now complete, and so that the scripture would be fulfilled, Jesus said, I thirst.
Thank you.
jar of vinegar was there. So they soaked a sponge in it, put the sponge on a stalk of the hyssop plant, and lifted it up to Jesus' lips. When he had received the drink, Jesus said, "It is finished."
Thank you.
sixth hour. And darkness came over the whole land until the ninth hour, for the sun stopped shining. And the curtain of the temple was torn in two. Jesus called out with a loud voice, "Father, into your hands I commit my spirit." And when he had said this, he breathed his last.
Thank you.
Good Friday service comes to an end. I invite you to sit with this, sit with the melodies, sit with the words, with the sorrow and with the silence, and ponder as we wait for Easter Sunday. Peace be with you.